Good afternoon, everyone. Well, I think you know my name is on the screen, and I was here my first trip to the U.S. 1970 or something, and because I was invited my employee to be with them for a business trip. Then we landed in Hawaii, Honolulu, and it so happened that Elvis Presley is there. And we stayed in the same hotel. And stayed in the 14th floor, and we stayed in the 12th floor. So my friend, who is so crazy about him, wake me up so early. Said, let's go and watch the movie, The Blue Hawaii. So that will be in the movie. I said, we are not an actress. So, but never mind, just said, we just go there, and then we'll watch, so that will be in the movie. So, after 2 to 3 months, we go back to the Philippines. And then again, I come back here, 1918. To have another business trip. And then when I go up there, so often that my husband told me, can you be my wife? And I said, well, maybe that's a good idea. And then so we got married, and then after a year, we have one son. And then after 5 years, I was blessed with my handsome Michael. So I said, well, and then later on, maybe God doesn't want me to have any more, to have only 2 sons. And after that, 1918, I was again here because I was assigned to be with the company where I worked with. And I said, well, I think I have to go home because I'm tired of coming here. But I said, well, back home, I'm so arrogant and so proud. I don't care about other people. I just care for myself because of the company that I'm with. You know, when you are with those people, then you have a little money, you have this and that, you can do anything you want. That's why I prayed to the Lord, said, Lord, please help me to be humble, not to be proud. Because I know being proud is the bad thing, that the Lord doesn't want you to do that. So I prayed and prayed, and then so happened that my son said, Mama, it's not a little girl. And then he gave me the book, Speak to Christ. And I read it and I said, wow, it's true what he's telling me. Because he told me, why do you have to confess to the person that he cannot even forgive yourself? It's just the same as you are. So I think about it and said, well, maybe. So I learned to study the Bible with Pastor Pry, that was in Simi Valley. And I said, well, first time I don't want to, but the pastor said that we are not forcing you to be with us, just listen. But I said, I'm a firm Catholic. I said, well, he said, we are not forcing you to be with us. And then I don't know why all of a sudden, early in the morning, I wake up and pray to the Lord, said, please help me the right way, because I'm in the wrong way. Back home, I'm really so proud. I put you down because you are like on my level. And I don't listen to my family because I'm really a strong-hearted lady. Because I'm the first grandchildren of 7 brothers and sisters of my dad. So whatever I want, they want. They give it to me. Said, you slaughter some chicken, I want some chicken today. And I said, okay. Oh, And then I said, I want some pig, some pork, and slaughter some pork. So believe me, it's not really a good one because it's not good to be spoiled. I don't like the word spoiled. Yeah. Spoiled is no good, because it's spoiled, it's rotten. So that I said, well, now, so back to my son. I said, Mama, please, I said, you are not too old to learn. So I changed my attitude. I become so humble. I know how to wash the dishes already. I know how to drive already. I know how to clean the everything. I even learned how to apply to be a housekeeper in Circus Circus. Because I have a friend here who owns the hotel, Westward Hotel, Mrs. Pam Peterson. And I said, how can you work here I said, well, you want me to be a member of the union, because you cannot work there without a member of the union in Las Vegas. So he told me, what do you want to do? I said, well, I want to be a housekeeper in Circus Circus. So I worked there in Circus Circus for, I think, a month. And then I'm tired of hearing I'm tired also of smoking in the casino and also hearing all these things that's going on. And then, okay, I said, I told my friend, Mrs. Peterson, I said, Pam, I have to go back to L.A. She said, too soon? I said, yes, because I don't want to smoke the cigarette in the casino. So I come back to L.A. and then I started to pray to the Lord that I have to be like my other family, that they are so humble, they are so kind, they are forgiving. So that's what I did. So I come back to LA and that's it. I think that's my story, I think. I cannot tell you anything. It's nice for you to hear my story. And God bless everybody. Because you are all my brothers and sisters. And in the name of Jesus Christ. Okay.